Here we are back at People's Park. Damn near trip this now. Gonna do a little action today for better health care. Go get a puppy.
Hey, puppy. Hey, puppy.
I can say,
one officer watching us right now.
Okay, you're good to go. Hey, you cheat! Yeah, is this postseason? 99 still here, baby! Oh, yeah. Occupy is still here! We're fighting for health care!
Not bad.
So you kept your beard?
Yeah, I mean, I've always been. And my boyfriend would be mad if I shaved it. He thought I was shaving it yesterday. And he came running into the bathroom. He's like, you're not shaving, are you?
Dude, I cried when I shaved. At first, I was going to do the Motorhead, just the fucking handlebars going off. Too thick, too thick.
Need to get some sound bites for us on the radio on here too. So, they're not here, or are you working with them?
Nigel's partner works with Westfeld.
Okay.
So that's where they get some audio. Hopefully, we're trying to branch out.
Yeah. No, that's cool. No, thank you, though. Thank you.
There's nothing just real warm.
Occupy Action's coming up. Occupy Action's coming up. Hey, listen to
them. What's that?
Can I give you upcoming action?
What am I saying?
Thank you, Maria. Upcoming action. Hey! It's a
global
reunion.
Hold on.
Oh, are you okay?
Oh, yeah.
Party foul. You got to drink a beer now, Alan.
Okay.
I can't wear this around my coat.
Get your signs here. Hey, signs.
We got hot fresh signs! Come and get them!
What's all that I do?
Shocking colors.
I just want to make sure someone had it.
Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Bring out your dead. Bring out your dead.
I understand we should speak with you.
I have to push that. We're talking about
the march. Should take 2 minutes.
The person to talk to you about this action, though, is Kristen Feldman.
Kristen.
Okay.
I need to get. Could you take this?
Oh my God, and she wants. I can't.
Volunteers? Yeah. My
daughter.
Sometimes we just want to talk to somebody about the event. So whoever.
I'll hold it up. Somebody else will hold it up.
Are you hold this? You hold that. I'll hold this. And then tell us the location that we have.
Hey, I still have your tool.
When, tonight?
Yeah.
I'm not sure. What time is it?
4 o'clock at the Gay Lesbian Community Center.
Where's that at?
It's right down
within walking.
You know where FedEx is? If you're going down, if you're walking down Grant towards
Yeah, I might attend that
before. All right, so I have it. It's in a box, and I want to get it back to you.
Yeah, right. That was great.
I got so much people shit in my car right now from.
Oh, I suppose scattered stuff. Oh, I bet. Yeah. Well, you know, that's the time to regroup, and you know.
Hell yeah.
So, that's great.
Let's switch this around so it's in my front. Oh yeah.
Mel was saying earlier, healthcare
is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight.
Okay, she's dead now. Let's go. Healthcare for the 99%.
All right, guys, thank you for coming out today. I really appreciate it. Healthcare for the 99% is very important, obviously. That's why we're all here. We're going to walk down this urban open space and go to UPMC to let them know how upsetting it is that they prefer profits over human life.
Yeah.
So, let's go.
All right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right.
Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight. Healthcare is a human right. Don't give up without a fight.
Healthcare is a human right. Hey, call me.
No. Thank you, though.
No!
The mother part of me wants to, like, throw him out for you.
No!
People die. Health insurance is a lie. They don't care if people die.
alive. They don't care if people die. Health insurance is a lie. They don't care if people die.
This man is sick and dying.
No.
You can't see patient.
He's got to be money, money, money.
Does he have insurance?
I hope so.
Does this man have health insurance?
He's serving us at
the money first.
What?
You're gonna check the cash. Look.
Take your money.
He's sick and paying me. Money. Money, 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 money. Every patient gets a dollar. No doctors allowed. Insurance company determines the price of all payments. Managed care. For profit insurance.
We at UPMC, Tyler, Aetna, Cigna, Coventry, WellPoint, United Health, and Humana Health want you to know that nothing, absolutely nothing, takes priority over your cash. We take your cash as if our bonuses depend on it. We believe that it is profit, the needs of profit, the profit of profit that doesn't have access to enough profit, that should be our top priority. Yay! 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 That serves our role as a leader in accumulating advanced levels of revenue across many medical and surgical types. It also affirms our position as a leading research institution with a commitment to pursuing life-changing profit margins and predatory business strategies.
Patients over profit! Patients over profit!
Some of our recent innovations include Ronald A. Billion, $18 million total CEO compensation at
Too much.
Alan Y, $17,427,000 total CEO composition of entries.
Too much.
Angela Briggs, $13 million total CEO compensation. United Health, Stephen Helmsley, $8,900,000 total CEO compensation. Cigna, David Cordoni, $6,500,000 total CEO compensation. Humana's Michael McAllister, $6,509,000 total CEO compensation. HealthNet's Jay Geller, $3,643,000 total CEO compensation. With numbers like that, I think you can see that we play a really important role in generating profit for the 1%. I'm really glad you came out today. We can't stay because it's too cold for us. But we hope you have a really nice rally. We'll be somewhere that's climate control. Thank you again for listening to me talk.
Patients over profits! 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 Patients over profits!
Patients over profits! Sorry. Now, Dr. Moore has a message for everyone that he wants to share. All right.
Can y'all hear me?
Yeah!
I'm gonna go without the mic. I've got a loud voice. We come here today to march and rally for healthcare. But we have to ask ourselves, what is healthcare? Is it having health insurance? any access to emergency medical care? How does this nation, allegedly the richest nation on earth, define health care? Health care is defined in this system as being granted the right by our bosses or by the state to use a significant percentage of our earnings to purchase, not to receive, but to purchase an insurance plan that then grants us the exalted privilege, as if it is a gift to cherish, to beg the insurance company that took our money for some sort of health care when we need it, to purchase the right to have claims denied, to have care denied, to have the right to go to a hospital or practitioner and pay additional co-pays for a visit that was paid for many times over in the form of premiums paid. Healthcare in America is a stain on our moral fabric. It's a turn away from our moral responsibility to each other, and it is destruction of our innate moral compass that says we must and should care for each other. Healthcare in America has given us, despite monetary outlays far greater than any other nation, morally and qualitatively deficient healthcare that leaves us the largest spending by capita over any other industrialized nation, and ranked 37th in overall healthcare, behind Costa Rica and just ahead of Slovenia. 39th in infant mortality, 41st in maternal mortality, 36th in life expectancy, with 47 to 50 million uninsured who have not even the most minimal of healthcare paid for by insurance plans. About one half of all family bankruptcies caused primarily not by mortgage debt, but by healthcare costs. Thousands of families forced daily to make the choice between food on the table or life-saving medications such as insulin for a diabetic family member. This cannot be tolerated nor allowed. It is a cry for justice. It's a cry for the right to occupy our nation with a different and a better system of health care, a new direction, return to community and family values that most of us live by in our daily lives. Not the warped version of family values proposed by pandering politicians, not just those who seek office, but by those who hold office currently, including the occupier of the White House, who pretends to health care reform.
That's right.
But his version of health care reform promotes a system that increases profits for the health care insurance providers and makes them richer every day. We need to return to family values and say, you are my family. And I must care for you, and you, as you must care for me. We must not be persuaded. We must not be persuaded that we are responsible for just our children. We must understand that the children of Alabama and Birmingham, Alabama, and Portland, Oregon are also our children. Children in every corner of this nation are our children. We have a shared vision of the future for not only our grandparents, our parents, ourselves and our children, but for all the grandparents, parents and children who live and work in this nation. And I stand here today to challenge America and to challenge all of us, and myself included, to build a nation, even to build a world, that has as its moral underpinning a set of values that trumps capitalist greed, that says no to profits over people, that says we will not, we cannot do less than demand health care for all. That the system that allows profits to be made from human misery must be buried on the landfill of human history.
Right.
From cradle to grave, block to block, coast to coast, from the mountains back to the sea, we have to stand firm in a demand that health care is a right. It's not a privilege.
Right.
It must be not granted, but guaranteed as a human right to all, regardless of color, ethnicity, sexual choice, for we're all human beings, deserving of nothing less. This battle and struggle, the collective effort to win health care for all, must not be compromised by being a small step from politicians eager to win our votes. In the coming months, we will find many, and most of them will come from the allegedly progressive Democratic Party, who will claim they share our beliefs, but that sadly we must only take incremental steps that might possibly, maybe, perhaps, when pigs fly and politicians stop lying, might create some minor reform in a corrupt, profit-driven system. Do not be fooled. They lie. They are owned by a criminal class that believes only in exploitation, in selling votes for bribes that they call campaign contributions, and we must deny them our votes until they stand shoulder to shoulder with you, you, and you, and me, and demand universal health care for all, and find candidates outside of the two criminal parties who do support our demands. Finally, let me say we must fight for health care, not out of personal or selfish desire, but because we must, because we are obligated to each other, because we have a moral responsibility to care for each of us. Because our vision, the vision we have, is a world in which people must not worry about overdue bills, not be afraid to go to a doctor or hospital for lack of money, not fear the phone call from bill collectors because they want money for their emergency appendectomy on your child, not live in fear of bankruptcy due to overdue medical bills, mostly inflated by capitalist greed, but a world in which we understand that we will only all live better when we all live better, and health care for all is part of making that a better world for all of us.
My name is Scott Tyson. I'm a physician with the Physicians for National Health Program. Oh, you can't hear me? Can you hear me now?
Hold on.
Push the button. Sorry. I'm not as loud as I think.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah,
my name is Scott Tyson. I'm a physician with Physicians for National Health Program. Oh, let me have my speech, please. Thank you. I want to let you know that there are nearly 20,000 physicians who are with you today who are supporting the Occupy movement. I want to read the statement from those physicians. We support Occupy because we took an oath to do no harm, and our corrupt political and economic systems are harming us all. We support Occupy because the healthcare economy, like the overall economy, has ample resources to take care of 100%. But those resources are siphoned off by profit-driven corporations like UPMC in the interest of the 1%. We support Occupy because our political leaders, held hostage by corporate money, reject evidence-based health policies such as single-payer reform that would save both lives and money. We support Occupy because we believe in evidence, and evidence shows us that profit-driven health care decreases access, raises costs, and lowers quality. It's unhealthy for the 99%. Only a few corporate executives, like Jeffrey Romoff, bankers, and lobbyists benefit. We support Occupy because healthcare is a human right. We reject a system that forces us to treat patients differently based on their insurance and the treatments they can afford. We support Occupy because economic and social inequalities make our patients sick. Low wages, high unemployment, inadequate education, unhealthy food, unaffordable housing, unsafe jobs, a polluted environment, and a lack of access to affordable health care breed death and disability. And this goes for the people in Braddock, where Jeffrey Romoff single-handedly and instrumentally tore a hospital down that had been there for over 100 years. We support Occupy because the private health insurance industry exemplifies the Occupy movement's central tenet. It's unchecked corporate greed tramples human need. We support Occupy because we are hopeful that we can change our society. Of all the forms of inequality, injustice in healthcare is the most shocking and inhumane. Martin Luther King. Everybody in, nobody out. Everybody in, nobody out. Everybody in, nobody out. Everybody in, nobody out. Everybody in, nobody out.
Everybody in, nobody out. Everybody in, nobody out. Everybody in.
I know what's going on here, guys, but if you're like me, your blood's boiling.
Yeah.
I don't know what you call people who deny care to the sick, but I call them murderers. So we're going to walk behind us into that lobby and tell them that we want health care for the 99%. And then we're going to walk down the street and we're going to say the same thing to Highmark. Because they're equally as guilty of these crimes against humanity. Let's go!
What do we want?
Now! What do we want?
Healthcare! What do we want? What do we want? What do we want?
What do we want?
Healthcare!
What do we want?
Now!
What do we want?
Healthcare!
What do we want?
Now!
What do we want?
What do we want?
Everybody in! Nobody out! Everybody in! Nobody out! Everybody in! Nobody out!
soon. I hope you're on the show.
I got a power down, man. I hope we have another battery.
Yeah, sidewalks, they'll get you for obstructing a sidewalk. They give you a lot of
warning. Oh, fuck. We're good for 20 minutes, though.
It's like 2 a.m.
It's too high, Mark!
Cheating his best friend in the head when he was younger.
How you guys been? Had a couple days off, feeling good?
Days off really haven't happened, but...
See, you trimmed the beard?
Yeah, no, I
had an interesting morning.
Right now, okay.
I slipped and tripped under the street.
Yep. Can you please speak
I was like this, and I saved my car.
You'll visit the next criminal.
Okay,
where next? Hi, Mark. Hi, Mark.
Yep, hi, Mark.
Oh, Sandy.
Oklahoma.
See what you're wearing.
Well, see, because we're not camping anymore, I figured I'd pull out my hipster wearing.
I love those boots, man. Sammy, those are beautiful.
I was like, Randy found them in a dumpster. Randy found these boots in a
really?
Fucking dumpster.
Cool.
Yes, I love his boots. I was like, fucking right, I'm wearing these. Oh, my God.
I know. Freshman year.
You find them
amazing. I just got myself a good pair of boots. I got myself this.
Hi, Mark.
Hold on. It's human rights. Hold on. It's human rights.
Doctors here to help. Oh, where'd the American flag come from?
Goodwill? There's one in Northside. It just fell down about.
We can get Crown Street! Crown Street! Crown Street!
Started second one's charged up. Otherwise, go to ustream.tv/channel/#OccupyPittsburghPGH.
This is what democracy looks like. This is what democracy looks like. This is what democracy looks like.
I gotta change the battery soon.
My camera's like, I'm not like the control now. Get me one of them, but I want to power it.
I got 7 minutes till I gotta recharge.
Healthcare for 99%.